Okay, so now we have unsafe consumption of APIs. So we are in, hard to believe, it's the 2nd of August, 2023. So I think all applications that we're building are consuming third-party APIs. So UCA happens really when we fail to validate the output from those APIs, and that can leak malicious content into our own systems. So for example, let's assume it's an example you touched on already, José, that we have a process for setting up a user profile. We may pull information from a third-party app or API to help us hydrate that profile. Potentially, a malicious user might have set up some data in that third-party app. So they might have put in an injection type of query into a particular value. Maybe that third-party app is, you know, correctly escaping that and not executing anything. But if we pull that information, perhaps that would be persisted and executed on our side, which could cause harm for our backend storage. So José, what can folks do to help overcome this type of situation?
Right. So I think the first thing we have to do is embrace zero trust approach. So normally we understand that we can't trust input from our users as it is. We have to do some validation, some filtering, sanitization of the input, and so on and so forth. I think we have to understand, like you said, we're 2023, a lot of integrations out there. We have to bring this approach to our integrations with other systems, not because those systems are necessarily malicious, but because users may find a way to introduce malicious content into those sites. Like you said, those websites maybe are doing things correctly, escaping values or parameterizing them, and so on and so forth. So maybe they are not vulnerable to that, but they may be exposing our system indirectly to those vulnerabilities. So we want to make sure we are adopting this zero trust approach. We validate that data incoming from those integrations. Those integrations have APIs, they have documentation. We know the schemas, we validate according to those schemas. And if the inputs or the output, the data they are sending to us is invalid, we reject it. We also want to make sure we are sanitizing, filtering, and inspecting that content, and that before we run that content through our database, make sure we are parameterizing all of our queries so that that data gets inserted safely in our system. So definitely we want to do those things.